Okay, so this is pressed out, and you know what this garment reminds me of?
Before I started teaching on the internet, the first video that I watched was actually on the internet by a lady called Mushtaq, well, under the name of Mushtaq. And this reminds me of a cutting that actually for an armhole that she'd done. Can you see the cutting of this armhole and what it looks like? I've tried to take the, how can anybody have an armhole width that big? Now, if you look at the kameez itself, it's like a bottle shaped. There is absolutely no cutting whatsoever. The camera actually makes it look better than this. On this particular kameez, the camera is doing it justice. But if I was to show you, if you were to see this in person, then you would absolutely be disgusted. I mean, this is what you call, typically what you call paying to get your fabric ruined. Now, this is the back sleeve, and can you see the contour of the sleeve? If I leave it on the cutting table, the curve around here and then where it ends, and how can you fix something like this? I mean, the length of this is just forever, and then it just slopes out. So where is all this excess fabric going to go? And then it's supposed to end up here where it's ended up, if you are a self-taught or one of those followers of YouTube cuttings that actually teach like this, then please, be prepared to have the hanging, loose hanging, lots of gathers around the armhole. I mean, this is something that is going to be inevitable. It's not the cut that you actually use for making. If you just want to cover your skin and just for the sake of wearing something, for the sake of wearing it, I mean, if you look at this, the curvature of this arm has started from here and it's actually going all the way down. And then if I am to put these two together, oh, so how do I actually resolve this? Well, first of all, we need to add an extension there. I'm gonna have to do something to actually do that, and I'm gonna have to go deeper around the back of the neckline and perhaps trim this off. Obviously this is going to affect the length of the garment. So this bit, I'm going to add a little bit of a fabric there just to bring the armhole slightly up. Well, actually, I can actually do away with quite a bit of this anyway. Perhaps apply a little bit of a shape. Luckily, okay, to some degree that's improved it a fair bit. That's the back of the dress. Try and do the same to the front and see what we can manage to achieve.
Now you see one of the problems with this is the neckline is going to be way too high now, because by the time I've done this, the neckline, and then if I undo the neckline and take it down, once a neckline is gone, and to try and redo a neckline is just, not only is it tedious, but you cannot get the same result, and often the garment is ruined when you try and redo a neckline. Also, the neckline is way too wide. I mean, where it's supposed to end up here, then if you try and take it back there, what you're getting is you're getting gathering inside the neckline. So it's quite a bit off the shoulder, and I've no choice but to actually leave it off the shoulder. To be honest now, that probably has a certain degree of shape in this now compared to what it was. But the problem is that the kameez, as I've gone and taken some off the top, is going to present the problem of actually the length coming out slightly shorter than what it is. But as you can see, just by taking that small amounts of that excess away, it's already given the kameez the shape. Now on top of that, we have to open the jack and maybe perhaps go down an inch or so below what the already current marking is. Now, having cut the sleeves, hopefully now what we'll have is a better fitting sleeve as well, and the contour of the sleeve will actually give it a better fall.